Do you just love survival games, but hate being limited to just one planet to survive in? Well, Empyrean might just be the answer you're looking for. Welcome, my name is Serdachi, and let's warp into Empyrean, a highly ambitious space game developed by Ilion Game Studios. Graphics. Empyrean is not a bad-looking game, but it's not a looker either. It's simply mediocre. Animations are overall pretty damn unimpressive when it comes to the many animated entities in the game. On the other hand, Empyrean does often show picturesque moments of beauty in its environments and lighting effects. Due to the weather effects unique on each planet, all planets also have quite a distinct atmosphere, making them all feel very unique and oftentimes dangerous, yet enticing to explore. Weapons look overall quite good, but again, it's clear that graphically this game is still in early access. Gameplay. If you've ever played a survival game, you will feel right at home in Empyrean. The game features a rather intuitive playstyle and progression similar to other titles in the genre. But where this game truly shines is the sheer scale of possibilities. Since it's a survival game, you'll have to take care of your health, food, oxygen, temperature, and radiation. To do so, you can go out and hunt a good number of different animals, aliens, monsters, and even dinosaurs. Or you can go out and grab herbs to consume directly or produce into a more potent healing item. Now, to prepare for danger, you can suitably equip yourself with a variety of armors and mods to face any kind of danger, paired with a great number of different futuristic weapons that each feel fairly powerful and are great fun to shoot with. Each planet contains a wide range of different bases and complexes too, some of which are abandoned, that offer a great deal of exciting exploration and loot scavenging. Now, exploring these sites is quite interesting and satisfying, with the possibility of encountering pretty rare and hard to get loot, especially early on. Most bases are also well protected with defensive measures and a ton of hostile aliens inside, which makes venturing through them to pillage and plunder the many valuables often quite intense and entertaining. Each and every time you've managed to trace down the core of each base provides a sense of achievement. But the real beauty of this game is in the crafting. I mean, I've played a lot of similar games, but never has my mind been blown the way this game has due to the sheer complexity and possibility. And while you're playing, mining, discovering, or drastically shortening the lifespans of aliens unfortunate enough to be in your way, you gradually gain experience, which allows you to unlock blueprints that allow you to craft all sorts of things. A base, for starters, can be made to look like almost anything you want because of the game's feature to control block placement and block shape. This makes it possible to come up with the most creative and beautiful looking creations, expanded even further due to the option of changing textures and colors of each block with tools. But a base is just that, a base. It's rather dull, right? That's why in Empyrean, having only a base is just the beginning. Soon you can start building your first hover vehicle and pilot it. These can be used for harvesting wood or ore, offer easy and quick transportation, or they can be used as a combat vehicle. But if simply hovering over the ground is not enough for you, you can also build your own ship to fly both on planets and in space. And finally, if that's still not enough for you, you can eventually create your own capital ship and use it to carry all your other vehicles and straight up warp to different planets. Or just let it hang in space to use it as your evil supervillain base scheming a plan for galactic domination. Overall score. The good. Mind-blowing amount of building options. A truly impressive number of possibilities here, and it's without a doubt one of the game's biggest strengths. You can build a base on any planet you like, craft the most insane spaceships, or just use a big capital vessel as a mobile base, living like a nomad, going from planet to planet, with only your imagination being the limit. And the ease of changing block shapes and the sheer number of shapes available only improve the quality of your creations in terms of look and feel. Fast building. Empyrean makes it easy to effortlessly build large environments with minimal effort. Planet diversity. Each planet feels unique and authentic with its own atmosphere. Enemy variety. A great deal of different enemies keep encounters interesting. Smooth. Empyrean plays smooth and fluid right out of the box. Item quantity. Empyrean offers quite a bit of items and features improved items that can only be obtained by exploring the many bases seen in the game. Blueprints. The blueprint system works great in saving your build creations and transferring them from game to game. Points of interest and exploration. Empyrean has a satisfying sense of exploration with tons of points of interest scattered over each and every planet, and also in space. Tech tree. The tech tree is well balanced and makes leveling up satisfying. Since it's possible to basically unlock all recipes by your lonesome, it's not necessary to make concessions, you only have to worry about prioritizing the most essential recipes. Great progression. From crashing down in your escape pod to conquering the galaxy with a badass self-built capital ship feels like a long and epic journey few games can match. The bad. Dull mining. Mining manually without a hover vehicle is quite boring and feels like a chore. Rough start. The early stages of the game are not a good representation of what the game has to offer and makes it feel like a different game altogether. Animations and models. The animations and character models of the game are very lackluster and unimpressive. Boring AI. The enemy AI is incredibly predictable and boring, somewhat dampening the plus about enemy variety I mentioned earlier. Relentless enemy accuracy. Hostile turrets and aliens will mess you up and don't even feel bad about it. They have pretty much 100% accuracy, which feels really cheap. Immersion breaking walls. Since the planets are currently not yet fully 3D, you can run into immersion-breaking orange walls at the north and south wall of each planet, separated halfway by a green wall that functions as a loading screen. Repairing. Currently repairing your capital ship or base can be pretty tedious and inconvenient. Bugs. I've had the weirdest and often most frustrating bugs happen to me. Things like my small vessel not being able to fly anymore, despite everything being accounted for and in tip-top condition. Or worse yet, I've had it happen to me that soon after warping to a new system, my beloved capital ship that I've spent many dedicated hours building suddenly didn't recognize me as its owner anymore, and soon after I ended up fried and crispy by my own turrets because it saw me as an enemy. Yeah, that was a fun moment. I must mention this was in a multiplayer server and on patch 5.0, but still, be aware that the game might possibly screw you over in completely unexpected ways if you're unlucky enough. Closing words. I honestly have a love and hate relationship with the game. I mean, I love the game itself, but the game can really screw you up good because of it being early access and everything. Few games can make you lose progress as drastically as Empyrean, simply because of its structure. Now, chances are you'll never encounter anything like this, but I do feel it's important to mention. And when it comes to the developers, well, out of all the early access titles I've played, of which there are many, I'd rate Ilion Game Studios as one of the best, if not the best, I've seen. They are incredibly dedicated and update very frequently. And no minor updates either, no, all updates are substantial and they're quick to fix things. Because of this, I have very high hopes for this game and it's one of the reasons I continue playing and enjoying the game, despite already having put in over 150 hours. You can tell that this game is their passion and it shows. I'd also like to mention that most of the footage I've shown in this video is fairly new. I used to play a lot with my best friend on a multiplayer server, but because of a huge patch recently, I had to start over. To show most of the possibilities, I've also used a creative game, simply because I don't have the time to put in dozens of hours to show everything in the survival mode at this moment. Having said that, I hope this video at least gives a good impression of what you can expect when you buy the game. Is it worth it? If you like space and survival games, this game is definitely worth buying. It's kind of like what No Man's Sky promised, but mixed with gameplay elements seen in many survival games, with a pinch of Space Engineer style building, except much more focused on the actual gameplay rather than building itself. If you're in any way the building type with tons of creativity, this game can entertain you without a doubt for countless, countless hours. It is definitely worth the asking price of 20 euros. Thanks a lot for watching, people. My name is Sir Dutchy, and I wish you, as usual, a fantastic, survivable day. If you liked the video, be sure to check out what other games I've covered by checking out my playlists.